I want to give you a look at the latest V12 Lamborghini. The 6.5-liter vehicle is the quickest the Italian supercar maker has ever produced, with a top speed of 350 kilometers an hour. Let's get more from Lamborghini's CEO, Stephan Winkelmann. He joins us live from Geneva. Thanks very much for being with us. A very fine-looking car you have there. I mean, this is amazing. The ultra-luxury segment is growing. You certainly believe at Lamborghini it's going to grow 40% in the next 5 years. What area of the world will be driving that kind of growth and buying that kind of car we just had a sneak peek look at?
Let's say when we speak about the 40% growth, there is somebody saying that this is the market size which is growing like this. And there is a mix between the luxury market and the luxury super sports car market. The luxury super sports car market is stable since years. The car we are having next to me is the Aventador LP750-4 Super Veloce. It's a new car, and the biggest markets also in the future will for sure be the US, some markets in Europe like the UK, Germany, the Middle East, and also if we look into Asia, China and Japan.
There are a lot of people have been pinning hopes, I know, on China because of the rising sort of upper class there and the newly minted millionaires and billionaires we keep reading about. But there has been this crackdown on consumption as well. Have you felt that hit your business?
The Chinese, Greater China, is still now market number two, but it's almost 3 years that we are saying that there is a slowdown in pace. And if we compare the size of a super sports car market between China and the US, then China is 5 to 6 times bigger than China. And this is a sign. So there is still a lot to do in China in terms of interest for super sports cars like ours. But we are rock solid there. And we will see down the road if this is going to change in terms of more attention or less attention to the super sports car business. But we have a very balanced distribution in the major areas of the world. So 1/3 we sell in Americas, 1/3 we sell in Europe, and 1/3 we sell in Asia Pacific, approximately. So that we have also good balance if there are local crises coming up.